Hello and welcome to the Crystals of Sugar activity. In this activity, we will be growing sugar crystals and learn more about crystallization. Let's start.
So first we just got some wooden sticks in general. We didn't really have any skewers, so we just used chopsticks. And then we're gonna just get them all in the water so they're all watery and stuff. And then we roll them all in the sugar so that they're all coated and nice and sugary. And I don't wanna say delicious, but I'm gonna say delicious. We leave them until they're all dry and no water is left, and then we just repeat this process to all of the sticks. Now we are going to make the water solution. The water solution that we are making is going to be a 3-to-1 ratio, 1 being the water and 3 being the sugar. We're going to be using a 0.5 liter of water, and then we're going to triple that and then add it to the sugar, water a little bit later. Now we have 1/2 of the sugar that we need, and we're going to put that into this and wait until it dissolves. Now we add little bits of sugar, bit by bit, and continue until the water is all cloudy and we are unable to dissolve any more sugar and we've used up all of our sugar. So now, as you can see, it is getting a little bit more cloudy, so we just have to add a little bit more and it'll probably be ready for us to get all coloured and maybe flavoured. So now that all of the water is like cloudy and the sugar is refusing to dissolve, and there's a little bit extra that is not dissolving, it refuses to dissolve, we are going to be taking this off of the heat. We're going to let it cool. And then we are going to separate it and then colour it, and then we're going to do all the other stuff that we will show you later. We now have our sugar and water solution, our little sugar coated sticks, our tall glass cylinders or glasses, our colourings, optional, our flavourings, also optional, and our pegs. Try to get ones that actually fit on your glass. We're going to be adding in all of the flavourings and all the colourings. We're also going to be using different liquid ones and gel ones, just as an experiment. Now we are going to be putting all of the skewers into the coloured water, and we're going to be holding them up with all of these pegs. Hello, we are back after 7 days, well, 7+ days to be exact, and it is now time for us to take the rock candy out of their glasses. We have already done this one, as you can see, and we just let all the sugar water drip out of it. And now I am going to show you how to take out all of these. You can leave for more time if you want, but 7 days is idle. First, we are going to be taking out these pegs. Ooh. This one here got a bit tilted, but that's fine. We can deal with that. And now we are going to be cracking up all of this hard stuff that's on the top. Then we're going to be letting this drip a little bit first, just to get all of the main stuff. And then we just let it drip here. Okay, so as you can see, this bit is a bit stuck here. We didn't put it in the center, so it's now just tilted and stuck to the side. So we need to use some different tactic to take it out. So I think what we're going to do is
dump out the syrup and then run the cold glass under hot water so that all the sides come unstuck.
We have this out now after a bit of time under the hot water tap. But it's out and we're gonna let all of these drip and we will be back in a bit.
So, what was happening in that experiment? At the beginning of our experiment, we dissolved water and sugar together to make a solution. A solution is a liquid that contains different substances. The most abundant component is called the solvent, which means that in the solution, there is much more of this component than anything else. When the solution becomes colder, the sugar molecules are less happy to stay. This is caused by a property called solubility. They would rather stay with the other sugar molecules and are ready to form crystals again. In these conditions, when they meet other sugar molecules in the solution, they start making solid sugar crystals. In this experiment, we covered sticks in sugar before immersing them into a solution. You ask? We wanted to help the molecules to start crystallizing. It's easier for crystals to start growing on new ones rather than recreating their own. This is because crystallization takes place in two parts. The first, nucleation, when they're making tiny crystals, and the second, growth, when all those molecules are attaching to the already existing crystal nucleus. Creating a crystal nucleus can sometimes be very hard for the molecules. So instead, if you introduce a new crystal molecules that are already made, then it can be a really good way to help them out.
Thank you very much for watching. We hope you had a very fun time conducting this experiment. Please stay tuned because there are more crystal adventures to come.